Welcome to Time Beat Breaking News Channel. Here are our breaking news today.
1. China calls U.S. warships trip across the seas illegal. 2. Trump loyalists push to revisit election results.
The United States, China calls U.S. warships trip across the seas illegal. A U.S. Navy warship's passage through the contested South China Sea has stoked tensions between the U.S. and China. China has slammed the latest passage by a U.S. Navy ship through contested waters in the South China Sea as illegal. China spoke out after the guided missile destroyer USS Curtis Wilbur transited international waters near the disputed Paracel Islands. The operation violated its sovereignty and damaged regional peace and stability, according to the Chinese military's Southern Theater Command. The U.S. action increases regional security threats artificially, and is prone to misunderstandings, misjudgments, and maritime mishaps. The ship's maneuvers were described as unprofessional and reckless. According to the report, Chinese ships and planes pursued the U.S. warship. China has issued a statement denouncing the activities of the U.S. warship for the second time in 2 days. Meanwhile, the USS Curtis Wilbur asserted navigational rights and liberties near the Paracel Islands, according to the U.S. Navy. It stated that it operated in compliance with international law and that the passage demonstrates the United States' commitment to a free and open Indo-Pacific. The U.S. refuses to recognize China's claim to virtually the waters. It regularly conducts what it calls freedom of navigation operations to assert its right to sail in international waters.
The United States, Trump loyalists push to revisit election results. A lawyer from Detroit informed county commissioners this week in Sheboygan County, Mich, that the voting machines they used in 2020 may flip votes and throw an election. She promised to send in a forensic team to check ballots and scanners at no cost to the county. Supporters of former President Donald Trump chanted, "Stop the steal," at a town meeting in Windham last month, demanding that authorities pick their favorite auditor to investigate a 400-vote gap in a state representative election. At a Board of Supervisors meeting in San Luis Obispo County, on California's central coast, on May 4, a large number of citizens questioned whether voting machines had correctly recorded their ballots, with many seeking a forensic audit. Trump's supporters are questioning how their elections are administered and pressing public officials to revisit the vote count, wrongly insisting that Trump won the presidential race. Behind the scenes, a loose network of lawyers, self-styled election experts and political groups is bolstering community efforts by demanding audits, filing lawsuits and pushing unsubstantiated claims that residents are echoing in public meetings. The increasingly vocal protests 7 months after Trump lost the White House show how deeply the former president has undermined confidence in the nation's elections, an attack he began early in the 2020 campaign as state and local officials expanded mail voting in response to the coronavirus pandemic. Even as national Republican leaders say they want to move on from the last election, a rationale they used to expel Representative Liz Cheney, RYO, a Trump critic, from her leadership post last week.
Thank you for watching. We help you stay up to date all the news hourly. Please subscribe our channel to follow up the latest one.